Are you upset at others for being lazy, dishonest, or perhaps for needing too much attention? Or do you feel ashamed when you cry or show emotions in front of others, or when you don't meet expectations, or if you have failed in the past? These are just a few examples, and they can help you reveal your shadow self. If you want to know what that is, why it's important for you to understand it and how to deal with it, watch further. Hi, my name is Barchi. Welcome to this place in which I'm sharing everything I know from my spiritual journey as well as psychology for you to be the creator of your life. If you want to work with me, the link to my waiting list is in the description box down below. But let's get on with the video. What is your shadow self? Everything you judge, project onto others, deny, feel ashamed of, or hide related to others or yourself is most likely your shadow aspect. Shadow is a concept that was introduced to us by a Swiss psychiatrist, Carl Jung, and he speaks about the part of us that we disowned at some point in life. So, how did you get your shadow? What happened? Well, let's start with your creation. You are born into this life as pure love, radiant sunshine, who was completely open and perceptive to the outside influence, like a sponge. By the age of 7, you took in without questioning all beliefs from your parents, caregivers, and society at large. And this is based on what is okay to do and what isn't. Things such as, is it okay to cry or to be angry, or do you need to work hard? What is it that it's okay and what it's not? And all of that we call conditioning. So those early years, as well as later on in life, but early years were really detrimental. If you ever behaved in a way that wasn't accepted by your parents or caregivers or the environment, what your mind decided back then for you to survive, to get love, safety, and connection from the environment is that you had to deny or suppress those parts that weren't welcomed by others. And that is what we now call your shadow. So let's say you were punished if you spoke your truth or were too loud, which meant you had to change your behavior, because it wasn't safe for you to be loud. And now you might have a hard time tolerating loud people. You might even equate being assertive as being bad. You might not be aware, but the way you make your decisions and behave, all of that stems from the conditioned mind, which means that a part of you is running on outdated beliefs and defense mechanisms. No decision made from a triggered or pain or scarcity place was ever a good decision in the first place. Would you agree with that? Let me know in the comments. How to deal with the shadow aspect. So if you think about the shadow aspect as a part of you that was casted out as a young child, I hope that first you can have some compassion for it, because in reality, all that this part craves is love and acceptance. Being judged didn't help this part in the first place, so it won't help it going forward. The good news is, in the past, the shadow was created because of the environment. But you are the one who can make this part feel home again. And doesn't that sound empowering? I would definitely say so. Okay, do you wanna do an exercise with me just to kind of start a transformation. It's going to be super simple. So let's start. Grab a pen and a sheet of paper, and I want you to write down three things that you find really annoying with people or a particular person. It doesn't matter. Just write three things that pop in your mind and don't overthink it. And you can pause this video and continue once you're done. Okay, I will list these three as an example. First one is causing drama. Second one is someone not listening. And the last one is not being honest. So for each of these listings, I would like you to ask yourself with kindness and compassion always, where am I causing drama in my life? We are starting with the first one. And drama can look like your thoughts coming up with all sorts of ideas, such as catastrophizing, exaggerating, black and white thinking. You know, when you go out and think, oh my God, what if this happens? What if I get into the accident? What if someone steals this or does that? So that's actually you creating a scenario that didn't even happen. In a way, it can be dramatic, right? Okay, let's go with the second example. They are not listening. And I want you to turn it around. What am I not listening? Am I listening to myself? Am I really hearing what I think and feel? I want you to be honest and compassionate with yourself as you write this down, because it will be really, really helpful. And the last example, we can just follow the thread. And what did I say? They're not honest. Okay. Am I being honest with myself? Because sometimes what tends to happen is that I might, or my mind can talk me into something that I actually don't like. And then I almost convince myself that I actually like this thing. That's just an example. Has that ever happened to you? So that's just an example of me not being honest with myself. And again, this exercise is not about judgment, but accepting the human nature. You start that by self-awareness and knowing that you are in charge of your behavior and you can choose what to think and what to do. But first, you need to have awareness of all the traits in yourself, especially the shadow part, because if you push it away, it will just stick around and have power over you. You know, it's like trying to push cork under the water. At some point, it will just come up to the surface, and you never know when that is. It might be when it's the least convenient, and you don't want that, right? But if you accept your shadow self with kindness and compassion, you can actually discover that it holds a gift for you and you might learn how to use it instead of vilifying it. So I'm curious, what are your thoughts on the shadow? What do you struggle with? Let me know in the comment section. Going forward, instead of judging yourself, apply love, compassion, and curiosity towards this beautiful part, or rather all the parts of yourself, because they all deserve that. And this way, your life will change. I promise you that. Thanks for watching. Much love. See you next time.